There's two main situations where people are going to self-quarantine. One is if the public health authorities tell you to because you've had a high-risk exposure. And the other is if you've traveled to an area where we know there's a lot of transmission. And so those areas, currently you'd have to look at the CDC website, but you know, as of today, the areas were Iran, Italy, China, South Korea, and then many other countries in Europe. And so the U.S. is recommending self-quarantine for 14 days after return from those areas. So the self-quarantine that we're recommending at home or in an apartment is in a separate room and not exposing anybody else. So you don't want to expose the rest of your family. You don't want to go out and about. You can't just go to the grocery store because you might interact with other people. It's basically staying at your room, separate, alone, and then having somebody deliver the meals to you, etc. You can go to the bathroom, but like when nobody else is, like you don't want to interact with people on the way to the bathroom. If your spouse or another family member is sick, if they can take care of themselves, that's great, and you don't want to be around them because you could potentially get infected. You can deliver meals to them, to their door, give them coffee or tea or whatever they'd like, give them their medicine, but just leave it at the door and let them get it. If you need to take care of them, you have to take care of them. If you have a sick child, you're going to be close with them, but then the chances are you have a very high risk of getting infected.